There's no question Democrats have their eyes on knocking off Senate Minority Leader Mitch McConnell in 2014. The party has thrown its full support behind Kentucky Secretary of State Allison Grimes, who, despite a rocky start to her campaign, is proving to be a worthy challenger to McConnell. And that close race means money will be flowing freely throughout the election.
Anything is possible right now. We're in a situation where, because of the outside money that can filter into a Senate race, these groups can raise and spend as much as they want.
Media reports have been swirling for the past month that Kentucky's Senate race next year could reach the elusive nine-figure mark, making it the first Senate race in history to top $100 million. But Dave Leventhal at the Center for Public Integrity says it's not something we should expect to become the norm, at least not yet.
You're not going to see all Senate races having nine figures, but what you will definitely see is more and more Senate races going in deep into the eight figures. You're going to see $30, $40, $50 million Senate races.
Leventhal believes that while nine-figure races won't be typical in 2014, money will continue to grow over the years, and he says House races will see major increases in spending in the years to come.
You're going to have many of them going in well into the seven figures and definitely potentially the eight figures because of the House being so tight.
My fellow Americans, we're reaching the end of this campaign. And
to put this all into perspective, in 1984, when Ronald Reagan ran for office, the entire presidential election cost about $200 million. Today, McConnell and Grimes could top half that for just one Senate seat. For WashingtonExaminer.com, I'm Steve Doty.